in this video developing a power supply. And that power supply has to give out, say, approximately 100 volts at approximately 1 ampere and 60 volts at approximately 1 ampere. And it all has to be regulated between, say, 0 volts and the maximum voltage. So this is a video about such a very first approach. And here you see my first sketch. And I have to say, don't make it this way, etc. The only idea is here that I want to make at first the AC transformer, that's here. Such a transformer has to be properly tested before you want to use it. And I've tested this transformer with 5 20 watt 12 volt incandescent lamps in series, and that worked properly for, say, a few hours. The transformer got warm but not too hot, and that's of course an issue when you want to make a power supply. You don't want that your transformer burns out anyway. First stage will be here a filter that filters out noise, etc. Of course, always a fuse here on the primary, always a fuse here on the secondary, and perhaps this connection is not properly made because it must be made here. So after the fuse, and here is a bridge rectifier, this will be a voltage doubler, and here will be the switch with which I can switch between the voltage doubler and the bridge rectifier. So with the voltage doubler it's approximately 110 volts, and with the bridge rectifier it is approximately, say, 60 volts or 50 volts. And I want to use, this is only a first idea, it's a classical series regulator. I don't want to use, say, a bipolar transistor, so no 3N3055, but I want to use field effect transistors, MOSFETs, power MOSFETs, etc., etc. But all the principles stay the same. And the principle is this: when you, say, give a certain voltage in a voltage divider to the base or to the gate of a MOSFET, that MOSFET will give at its output the voltage that you have set here. And of course we need, say, smoothing out here, etc., etc. So this is a very experimental first idea about how to make the power supply, and perhaps or surely it will be changed in the future when I publish it. The transformer again, and here is the enclosure that I made. Well, this is only a first idea for such an enclosure. It's made of multiplex wood. Here are holes for ventilation, always necessary for a power supply, especially when it gets to higher currents, etc. Here a hole, and here, and also on the underside, and I have talked much more about that in the past. So here you can see through. This will be covered with mesh, and so that we have a lot of draft inside this box, and that draft is very, very necessary to cool all the components inside. This is the front plate. It's made of Pertinax phenol resin board, and this is, say, my kind of mock-up I want to use these two meters. So let me show the mock-up first. I'm now making a kind of template to drill this front. And I will glue this template, paper template, to the front and then drill all the holes, etc., etc. And here are the two, say, the voltmeter and the amperemeter that I want to use. I've changed the 1 milliamperemeter to a amperemeter that can handle 3 ampere. So, and this is the template. And here we have all these, say, connectors that I will use. Beautiful connectors. A red will be positive, black will be negative, so I've positioned them here on that mock-up. And I also want to take out of that transformer 6 volts AC. That is more or less simply because I found here on the transformer that these two wires could give out 6 volts AC at, say, perhaps 1 ampere or so. So I don't want to, say, lose that good property of the transformer. Perhaps I'm going to use that in the future. Perhaps for tube circuits, etc. EC tubes, European EC tubes, work on 6.3 volts AC as a filament voltage. So that's why I'm going to mount here that 6.3 or 6 volts AC. And here are the fuses that I will use. Of course, it's necessary to fuse the 6.3 output. When the current gets too high, the fuse will blow. And here will be the, say, fuse to connect the transformer to the 230 volts. So the main fuse will be here. And here another fuse. And all these fuses will be mounted at the exterior. That's important. When you do experiments, it's not a good thing to, say, have to open an electronic device completely to, say, replace one fuse. Be it of 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 10 ampere anyway. So that's the reason why I will mount all the fuses here on the front. A fuse can easily blow when you do experiments. Here there are some holes to which the meters will be fitted. This is a voltmeter, by the way, and here another voltmeter, but I've showed in the video of today also the amperemeter. And here I can switch between the two output voltages. And I've used here a double output connectors. That's always interesting and good to do that. Say, it's more or less practical. And here the potentiometer that will be used to, say, align the output voltage. It is, by the way, I position all these components to see how it will work on later. And this is a precision potentiometer that was salvaged out of an old laboratory equipment. Of course, it's not necessary for, say, many normal purposes to use such a precision potentiometer, but it comes in handy. And the fact that I had it in my store, say, why not use it when you have it? So, by the way, I'm not completely sure that I will use this potentiometer. Perhaps in the future I will need another value to say drive the output voltage anyway. Only first idea is to get, say, a good idea about how to, say, mount all the electronic components in a proper way. Of course, we also will have here a cooling plate, so heat sinks of the transistor stage, and for the bridge rectifier, and perhaps for the diode voltage doubler. So, it's only a first idea. And that was more or less everything to tell. When you want to develop a power supply. Of course, you can buy nowadays a power supply for, say, €50, $50, or perhaps $80 that can do the same job. Say, but the real interesting thing, the real joy is to make such a power supply yourself. Homebrew it. Gives a lot of insight, a lot of pleasure, etc.